Okay, so for those of you who hate fractions, I'm going to make your life so much easier, a little bit easier, when you're solving equations with fractions. I'm going to show you a way to wipe out the equation of its fractions before we even start solving, so that you never have to add or subtract with them, okay? So this equation has two fractions. Both of them have 3 as a denominator, so they're both being divided by 3. So the inverse of dividing by 3 is multiplying by 3. So if we do that, the inverse of the division, we should get rid of these fractions. So what you're gonna do is multiply the entire equation, because whatever you do to one side, you have to do to the other, by the denominator, by 3. So we're gonna multiply this entire equation by the number 3. Now what you have to remember is that every single term gets multiplied by 3. So there are 3 terms in this equation. Terms are separated by addition or subtraction. They'll all get multiplied by 3. Okay, so 3 times 1/3 x will give me 1x. If you need to see it the long way on the side, 3, which is the same as 3 over 1, 3 times 1 is 3, and 1 times 3 is 3, and 3 divided by 3 is 1. But the shortcut is really just to look at it and say 3 goes into 3 once, 1 times 1 is 1, right? So I just get a 1x there, which is nice, plus 3 times positive 6 is 18, equals 3 times 2/3. Again, you can do it the long way, which would be to say 3 times 2 is 6, and invisible 1 times 3 is 3, 6 divided by 3 is 2. Or you can just realize that 3 goes into 3 once, and then 1 times 2 is 2, okay? So we've done it, we just wiped out our entire equation of fractions, and now we have a really nice one-step equation, 1x plus 18 equals 2. I'm gonna subtract 18 on both sides. That's gonna leave me with 1x, or just x, equals negative 16. So there is my solution. X is equal to negative 16 in this problem. Let's do an example where there are multiple fractions, but there's different denominators, okay? So we'll figure out what to do there. So if we've got, for example, negative 3/4 x plus 1 equals 2/3. Now I've got a 4 as a denominator and a 3 as a denominator. So if you think you might know what to do it, pause the video, see if you can think about it before I say it, and see if you get the right answer. If you thought about multiplying by the least common multiple, which would be 12, you'd be correct, because 12 is divisible both by 4 and 3, so that means that if I multiply by it, it should wipe out all of these fractions. So let's do the same process. 12 times negative 3 over 4. So 4 goes into 12 3 times. 3 times negative 3 is negative 9x. I'm going to do it on the side the long way in case anyone needs to see it. So 12 times negative 3 over 4. I'm going to write my 12 over 1 because 12 divided by 1 is still 12. 12 times negative 3 is negative 36. 1 times 4 is 4. Negative 36 divided by 4 is negative 9. Okay? Again, the shortcut, the better you get at this, the faster your math will go. 4 goes into 12 3 times. 3 times negative 3 is negative 9. A little bit quicker. Okay? So let's keep multiplying. We have 12 times positive 1, so we have plus 12 equals 12 times 2/3. So again, two different ways, 12 times 2/3. I can look at it and say this is 24 divided by 3, which is just 8. Or the shortcut, I can say 3 goes into 12 4 times. 4 times 2 is 8. Again, I've wiped out all my fractions. Now I have a nice two-step equation. I'm going to subtract 12 from both sides. Bring down my negative 9x. 12 plus negative 12 is 0. 0 plus negative 9x is just negative 9x. 8 minus 12 is negative 4. One step left to getting x by itself, which is to divide by negative 9. Has to be negative, because negative divided by negative will give me positive 1. And I'll divide by this side on negative 9, or on this side by negative 9. And I get x equals positive 4/9, because this is a negative divided by a negative, which is a positive. So I get x equals 4/9 as my solution. Okay, so I'll do it the long way just so we can kind of go through the pain to appreciate the beauty of wiping out the fractions. So you see we do get the same answer. So if I didn't multiply by 12, then I guess my first step would be to subtract that 1 from both sides. So minus 1 minus 1. So now you might have to go on the side to do this. 2/3 minus 1. So you need common denominators. So 2/3 minus 1 is the same thing as 2/3 minus 3 over 3, which gives me negative 1/3. So on this side, I'm going to get negative 1/3 equals negative 3/4 x, because 1 plus negative 1 is 0. So now negative 3/4 is being multiplied by x, so I'm dividing by negative 3/4, but if you watched my prior video with fractions, I told you that it's the same as just multiplying by the reciprocal. Okay, so dividing by a fraction or by a number is the same as multiplying by that number's reciprocal. So if I multiply by negative 4/3, I'll get 1, because these all cancel out, I get 1, right? So I get x equals, and on this side, I'm also gonna multiply by negative 4/3. So I will get negative 1 times negative 4 is 4 over 3 times 3 is 9. Same thing, different way. So you guys look at both ways and see which one works for you. I think that for people who don't love fractions, it's much easier to just wipe them out from the beginning.